Missouri Valley Conference, but Cam Crutwig, Lucas Williamson have picked up the slack for the two-time defending champs. They're in to face the upstart Salukis, who have a crack at first place tonight. They've been unstoppable on their home floor, winners of eight straight in Carbondale. Eric McGill and company look to make it a season high, four-game winning streak. You're watching the Missouri Valley Conference on ESPN. Southern Illinois trying to add to that wall. A surprising first half of the Missouri Valley Conference for them. They can get into first place tonight as they take a crack at the two-time defending champs, the Loyola Ramblers. Connor Runyon with you, Mike Trude and John Miller here in just a few moments. Let's go back 2 weeks ago. The Salukis and Ramblers met up in Rogers Park, and it was the homecoming for former associate head coach Bryan Mullins, now the Saluki head coach, and the program that he helped build. Kind of came back to beat him. Tate Hall, one of the guys that he recruited, had a big night. Some bright spots for SIU, including Lance Jones and Eric McGill, but ultimately a 16-point win for Loyola. Since then, the Salukis have caught fire. Here's Mike Trude, John Miller with us here momentarily. But since then, the Salukis have won three straight. Now, all of a sudden, the team picked last can be in first place at the end of the night.
It's kind of an amazing story, being the hottest team in the league with three in a row. An opportunity with the win tonight to potentially have a share of first place.
Got to beat the champs at some point. Cram Crutwig has already won two of those for Loyola, including clinching one here a couple years ago.
And he's the preseason Missouri Valley Conference Player of the Year. He's doing nothing to hurt those chances this year. He is a dominant player facing the basket. He's their leading assist man, their top scoring man. He gets steals. He literally does it all for this Loyola team.
17 points from McGill. He was really the only one that had any offense in the first meeting.
He's been the Salukis' best player in the last five games overall, and that comes with senior leadership. He's averaging over 15 points a ball game. He's running the show, although he's playing the off guard, making big shots, keeping Southern in the game.
Mike Vic Koenig Chevrolet brings you the keys to the game. Hope the lifetime powertrain protection.
Yeah, for the Salukis, avoid long scoring droughts. They're against the best defensive team in the league, but they can't go 6-7 minutes without getting points on the board, and they have to make Loyola work for every single point that they try to score. For the Ramblers, get everyone involved. Crutwig is the main man, but when he can get Williamson and the other two or three guys, everyone can score. If they get going well, if they have a lot of assists, they're going to be successful. And control Barret Benson. They held Barret way down in the first ball game, and they won by 16 points.
Sure did. Already rocking in here. Best crowd of the year so far at the Banterra Center. And Loyola controls the tip. Winners of 11 of their last 14. Currently in a share of first place. And trying to win their fifth and sixth tries. It's a very good defensive Loyola team, but they're not too bad on offense either. They've really turned it on shooting the basketball lately. And their offense runs through this guy, Cam Crutwig. Averaging 15 points per game, he leads them in everything.
And that was pretty easy. He caught the ball top of the key, did not get double teamed, was able to barrel down the line and hit that short little lefty off the glass for two.
And that's one of those individual matchups that we are fascinated to watch tonight, him and Barret Benson. SIU, a slow it down offensive team. Fewest points in the conference. And there's that matchup again in Crutwig, 2 for 2 against Benson.
Yep, Barret left it short. Had a good look at the basket, just didn't get enough on the ball.
Everything changed for Loyola when Keith Clemens became their point guard. First year junior college transfer. And Cam Crutwig hits a mid-range shot. That's really the one missing piece of his game.
Yeah, and that was a nice little look. I mean, he's a 72% free throw shooter, so he can hit the 15-footer when nobody's guarding him. Nobody guarded him that time either.
SIU off three consecutive wins. That's a season high. They haven't lost since November at home, and McGill has it swatted out of bounds at 11 to shoot. Let's go to John Miller for the first time.
Yeah, guys, I want to take note that SIU wearing special black jerseys tonight as part of the Blackout Cancer Initiative. This is an ongoing initiative for SIU battling against cancer. But the fans had the opportunity to bid, to put names on the back of these jerseys. And they raised over $7,200 for this honor, all money going to the Coach Kill Fund, which fights cancer and other childhood diseases in the Southern Illinois area. So basketball obviously important tonight, but something bigger going on as well.
Yeah, great cause, John. The football team does it here at SIU. The women's basketball program will have their game on Friday. And the Saluki's not wearing white for the first time this year for a great cause. Look to keep the home streak going, and I hear Ukwok with some authority makes it 6-0 Loyola.
And there has been no defense yet played by the Salukis.
Crowd trying to get him into it. Yeah, that's a surprise. The Salukis have held opponent after opponent inside 60 points. And they're used to getting off the fast starts, but it's Loyola punching him in the mouth. Ronnie Suggs gets the defense from Tate Hall. And the tie-up keeps it down to this end. Now, let's not get anything mixed up either. Loyola can really defend, too.
They are the best defensive team in the league. Just ahead of Southern. So you might think first team to 60 is going to win this ball game, but Southern's got to get on the board to help that along.
Got to score one or two before he can get 60. Lukey's inbounded it with 9 to shoot. Lance Jones down the lane.
That's where he's improved his game. That little short mid-range little jumper went in for 2 at the end of the shot clock.
Really a classic matchup. You've got 2 newcomer point guards that are uber talented and 2 upperclassmen big men going at it in the post. Tate Hall misses down to Marcus Domask. Lukey's winners of 8 straight in this building. They're 9-1. The only loss against San Francisco, top 100 team. And Jones finds another seam and gets another one to roll home.
And he's showing immediately he can take that to the hoop anytime he wants against Clemens.
Jones scored the first 7 points in the last game for SIU. He had a career high 20 in the last home game. Scoring really starting to come on for Saluki freshman point guard. But Clemens gets fouled by Jones. It's a 3-point try.
And more importantly, that's 2 fouls on Lance in the first 3.5 minutes of the ball game. Here's the kick out. Got him in the stomach.
Clemens to shoot 3. And that's how you can. There's a look at Porter Moser, 9th-year head coach. 2-year champion for the Ramblers, but the Salukis can ill afford to lose their point guard, Lance Jones. Aaron Cook ruled out for the season with that hand injury. And now it'll be Trent Brown into the game.
And he's going to have to sit down for a while. We'll see what kind of a gambler Bryan Mullins is. Obviously, he would love for him to be able to sit out the rest of the half and not be out of this basketball game. It's going to be really interesting to see how they do this now with now McGill's got to take over the point.
Moser can put his starting point guard Clemens on the bench. Not a big drop off for Loyola when Marquise Kennedy comes into the game.
No, when he gets double figures, they're 8-1 on the season.
Lucas Williamson checking Eric McGill, who slithers in and 1. And McGill, the top scorer for the Salukis the last 5 games, adding to it.
Continues to take what the defense gives him. Great crossover dribble to get to the lane. Nice move to lay it off the glass, and he'll get the opportunity for the old-fashioned 3.
McGill missed a game for Bryan Mullins' team with the flu at Indiana State, but since then he's been on a tear.
Been really, really good, as he was last year, midway through the Valley season, caught fire for Southern as well.
Rutwig, an adept passer. Well, that one squeezed in and out of bounds off Tate Hall.
Good defense that time by the Salukis. No back door allowed. He had to thread the needle and wasn't able to. They turn it over, and Southern will have the ball when we come back from the break.
Well, we expect it to be a fight. So far, it has been. Defense reigning there of the last couple minutes of that first segment. But Cam Krupwig already has half the points that he had against SIU the first time.
And he does love playing against the Salukis in 5 career games against Southern, averaging 71% from the field, over almost 16 points a game, almost 7 rebounds per game, a nifty assist there. and stopping Frontwig is Southern's biggest chore in this basketball game. Making others beat the Salukis. Bryan Mullins won't necessarily like to live with that, but he thinks that's his best option.
Magic Johnson made the point forward pool. Cam Krupwig's making it more of a point center.
Yeah.
15 points, 8 rebounds, 5 assists tonight.
He's got 95 assists, 96 with the one tonight. That's more than double of any other player on their roster. That's amazing for a 5-man.
Amazing for a guard.
Yeah, it is.
SIU breaking some pressure against this Ramblers defense. Very similar schemes on the defensive end that you'll see tonight for both teams as McGill springs free for a dunk. 5 early points for McGill.
They tried to hedge on McGill and he split the defense right down the middle for the jam.
Paxson Wojcik into the game out of the timeout. Back into Krupwig, single coverage and too easy. That's the battle that Valley teams are having right now. What do? He's such a good passer. Do you double him? Or do you just take your chances that he's going to beat you for 20?
Yeah, if you double him, you have to double him with his back to the basket, not facing the basket, and Southern hasn't even attempted a double team yet.
See if Benson can hold his own on offense. He turns it over. Wojcik with the interception. Numbers back for SIU, but Krutwig with another great pass, and Kennedy has his first bucket.
6 points, 2 assists already for the big man. It's fun to watch play, isn't he? Just a junior.
Suggs on a back cut. Falls off the rim, but Suggs to the line for 2.
Really good look on the baseline, and Ronnie knew he had to catch it and go right up and not give them an opportunity to get defensive position. Drew the foul and will go to the free throw line for 2 as Wojcik gets the personal.
Especially without Lance Jones now that went to the bench with foul trouble. 2 fouls already for the Salukis point guard. They really need a guy like Suggs to emerge and score.
Yep. And down goes Benson. In comes Brendan Gooch. His toughest chore of the young season so far.
It'll be Gooch against Krutwig. Significant size advantage for Krutwig. Gooch just 6'6", Krutwig 6'9".
And at least 45 pounds heavier.
And they go right into Krutwig, and there he goes again.
That was a joke. I mean, that wasn't even funny. All he did was turn to his left, used his hind end to get Gooch out of the way, and had the easy layup.
Marwin Francois just in, and the miss, down to Krutwig. Got to think Krutwig's going to touch it every trip down in some capacity. He's handing off here to Wojcik. And now the Salukis tried to mask on the big man. And tapped away by McGill. Francois to sweep it up.
A late double team. McGill came over and swatted it away.
McGill on a stop and start. Discards Williamson. And McGill hot early on.
What a great stutter step by McGill.
This is a big challenge for him tonight. He's going up against one of the conference's best defender, Lucas Williamson. Salukis crowd in it early. Hand check, Marwin Francois. It'll be his first on the Hall drive.
That's the hardest position for Harwin. He's got to quickly come and double team if they get the ball to Krutwig, but when they faked it, he had to quickly get back out to the corner and got called for the foul.
Right now doing everything in his power to try to stay in front of Krutwig, deny him the paint.
Can't put your hands on him. You've got to use your chest.
Jalen Pipkins, one of the newcomers for Loyola. He's into the game. Bugwak has some three-point range. Francois able to clear it away.
They'll give Bugwak that anytime he wants it. He's 3-for-14 now on the year.
He's coming off a game where they had a huge second half surge to get their third consecutive win. Overcame a 10-point deficit. misses the deep three from Gooch, and it rims out. That's his spot, but not this time.
This is interesting. Southern coaches were calling out the play before it even started.
Ooh, Ugbok nearly banked that in from the corner. But yeah, I mean, Bryan Mullins spent 6 years in the Loyola program, mostly dealt with their defense. But they're able to go through walkthrough and practice and call them out by name and know what's coming. Turn around for Francois, short. Kennedy sweeping crossover. Lost it as Domask came over on the help. Ugbok on the attack and a foul. Get that one on Gooch. That's a break for SIU. And if it was on Francois, that would have been number two on another guard. Well, the fingerprints of Cam Drutwig all over this one already. He has 8 of the 15 for Loyola. A couple assists, a couple of rebounds too. Porter Moser versus his former assistant, Bryan Mullins, the Saluki head coach, but also Javon Maben, former Loyola director of basketball operations, now on the Saluki staff. Let's go over to John for more on that.
Yeah, Connor, you're exactly right. Everybody knows about the connection with Bryan Mullins in Loyola, but he brought Javon Maben with him here to Southern. Maben was a high school coach in the Chicago area when Porter Moser picked him on his staff as the director of basketball operations. He was a part of that Final Four staff. Now he's here at Southern. So not only does probably Bryan Mullins know some of the plays, Javon Maben has a hand up as well.
Yeah, good stuff, John. Javon was a high school coach on the south side of Chicago. He would drive at 4 a.m. up to see spring workouts, some of the fall workouts, and that impressed Porter Moser so much that he put him on staff, and Maben impressed Bryan Mullins too to bring him along here to Southern.
Yeah, it's impressive. Driving all those miles, early morning, late hours, when he could have been doing other things, leads to the coaching job.
And Rogers Park is not in the near north side.
No.
That's a long drive that he was making down Lake Shore Drive. Williams in the miss out of the timeout.
We talked about this maybe being a defensive struggle. Loyola shooting 67%, the Saluki shooting 56%.
Okay, so good preview we gave, right?
Yeah.
And the defensive numbers the exact same. 62.2 points per game that both teams are allowing coming in. McGill gets hit. Max and Wojcik got him.
That's two on Wojcik. The lost art. 15-foot pull-up jumper, and Wojcik got him on the elbow.
Yeah, the analytics hate that shot, but still counts for two. Especially if you can get to the free throw line and make a couple. So far, McGill has been the best player for SIU. Tate Hall's back into the game.
72% free throw shooter from the line as well. He's done it all so far tonight. Going for his ninth point.
He does have 9. Even at 15. Close to the midway point of the first half. Saluki's in that comeback victory against Illinois State last week. Eric McGill almost single-handedly turned it, according to a lot of his teammates.
Had a great second half, as did his freshman partner, Domask. Boy, Williamson just went right around everybody. They're having no trouble getting to the glass right now.
Williamson lauded for his defense, but coming off an 18-point game and a loss against Northern Iowa. Keith Clemens is back in. Wondered when we might see him again with Lance Jones with the Salukis on the bench. A strong drive from Domask, no bounce. And Franklin Agunani had the rebound, fending off Barret Benson. Clemens, they went under the screen and he pops it in the Saluki's face.
His 17th three of the year. He's over 40% from long range. Just a nice pull-up three. When you go under the pick, then you're giving yourself up for that three.
What a difference that Clemens has been since he got healthy from that E injury. Ramblers haven't stopped winning since he's been reinserted. And the miss from Karrington Davis. And a foul on Benson.
Barrett didn't like it. We're going to see the long miss. And Benson, a little bit on the elbow. And Benson goes out. Gooch back in with Ronnie Suggs.
Southern not very deep at Benson's spot either because of injuries. Siku Dembele out for the year. Broke his leg at Bradley for the first Loyola meeting. Zaid Hall into Agunani, and he walks with it.
And Porter Mosier didn't see the travel. Complaining to the officials, he said, what did he do? He pivoted, he dribbled the entire time.
This is your favorite coach watch, I'm sure. You're always quick to note attire and when the jacket's on or off. That's his thing.
Yeah. And he usually does a pretty emphatic take off of the jacket.
He's got his own Twitter account. Three for Trent Brown.
Well, he was squared up, just missed it to the right.
Hesitation from Clemens, he creates for a Tom Welch three. The lightly used freshman forward from Naperville makes it an 8-point Rambler lead.
His first three of the year, he's 1 for 2 now.
Step back three, Ronnie Suggs, much needed for SIU.
Stopped the bleeding a little bit, still a 5-point deficit. Southern has to do better defensively. They've already given up 23 with 11 and a half minutes gone in the first half.
Deflected by McGill, stolen by McGill. See the numbers back for Loyola. Two very disciplined transition defensive teams. McGill with a quick shot. Right back at you, Loyola. SIU on a 5-0 run.
And McGill stole the ball on the back end, came to the front court, held court for a little bit, then pulled up when his man went again underneath the pick, drained the three.
This game didn't already have enough billing. The players of the week in the conference, both in this game tonight.
Yeah, Cam Crutwig, he's won a bunch of these already. It's the second time this year for Marcus Domask to win the Newcomer of the Week award. He's going to win some more of these awards as he goes along. Maybe not Newcomer, but he's a good player. He's going to be up for those Valley Player of the Week, as is Crutwig. And it's nice to have both of those players in this game tonight. And Domask has yet to score, but he makes his mark on the game in other ways as well when he's not scoring.
He sure does. It'll be a tug of war for those accolades at least the next 2 years. Crutwig, a junior, and Domask, a freshman. So it was a 6-0 run right before the timeout for SIU. Back-to-back threes by Suggs and McGill. And a quick whistle. Cam Crutwig causing some problems down to the low post again. Actually, it was on Davis out on the perimeter. That's number one.
Holding out on the perimeter. They're calling it pretty close tonight.
Yeah, Loyola's already in the bonus. Lemon shut off. We got two point guards out there with Crutwig. Another easy bucket for Crutwig.
And how good was Crutwig on that one? He knew if he brought the ball down, he comes down to their level, kept it above his head, went right over the rim for an easy two. He's got double figures already.
He wasn't going to have a game like he had against Southern the first time. 8 points, he only got 6 shots up. But he saw double teams all night and burned SIU for 5 assists. Davis slashing with mean intent. Missed everything. And Suggs misses the three. Ooh, that's the flashiest we've seen Karrington Davis since he's been back from his Achilles injury.
His explosiveness is amazing. as we see Clemens travel with the basketball. Davis just shows these moments of what fans are going to see for the next 3.5 years here. He hasn't yet been able to put it all together, though.
He's got a chance to take over some games, and he's right. We walk back in, and how about this? Lance Jones back in, 7-minute mark. The Saluki point guard playing with two fouls.
Big moment here for Lance. See what he can do. The final, probably maybe get him under 4 or 3 minutes, take him out again. Try to play foul free, but still be aggressive. Hard thing to do.
Gooch off a kick out. Man, both of his shots have been halfway down. Krutwig through traffic and one. Cam Krutwig having one of those nights. He is already 1 point. 3 points away from his average. He's got 12.
And Mullins yells down the bench for Barret Benson to get back in there. Suggs called for the foul. And I think Barret Benson has now been challenged.
What do you mean?
I mean, he's got to try to stop Krutwig. He's done whatever he's wanted to in this game so far, and Benson's been there for a good chunk of it.
Did it himself.
Now he's got to do it on the other end.
2 points, no rebounds for Barret Benson. The first time that SIU played Loyola. Loyola's a team that recruited Barret Benson. Ultimately got away from the Ramblers to the high major ranks. And Ugwak, late whistle on Damask.
No argument from Marcus, though. Ugwak catching it. Down low and definitely grabbed his left arm going up. So he's going to be at the free throw line shooting too. And Loyola is catching the ball deep on the block. Both big men.
That's a cardinal sin for both of these defenses. Both Corey Moses' defense and Bryan Mullins' defense. They are no middle pack line type teams. Brings it back to 7 for Loyola. And one on Clemens in the backcourt.
They are really calling this tight.
Well, two physical, defensive-minded teams, and the precedent has been set very early. And a hook a little off to the left. Rebound for Loyola with Kennedy. And one of the fastest players in the conference lobs it up top. Ugwak stuffed by the rim. And Damask loses it. A rare turnover for the Saluki freshman. 2-on-2, and Ugwak foul.
And if somebody would have just gotten in his way, he would have charged right into him. But McGill's going to be called for the region on the foul. Oh, they called it on Suggs. That's 2 on Ronnie now. Southern getting in some foul trouble.
Back to back trips at the line for Ugwak. Cousin of Luol Dang, who spent 10 years in Chicago. He was a Bull from 2004 to 2014. Funny, Ugwak said that he actually cheered against his cousin Luol Deng sometimes because they were playing against his favorite player, LeBron James, on many occasions.
He did not score in the first meeting. He's got 5 today.
Benson down there. Krutwig sending him off by himself. Now inside 10 to shoot. McGill left his feet. And more transition points for Loyola coming. And Kennedy finishes it off balance. So two slow tempos, but Loyola will pick their spots and run when they can.
And they're up 10 now, and they're really clamping down on defense. Southern really having to work hard for their just to get shots off.
Well, there's an open one for Barret Benson. He's hoping that can soften up that one-on-one defense with Krutwig.
I'm sure they'd like to get another foul on Benson here.
Ugwak probing in on Domask. Oh, Benson lost it. Back to Ugwak, offensive foul. Scary moment there for SIU.
Nice recovery by Barret after he lost the rebound to get back into position and grab that offensive rebound on the drive by Ugwak.
It is the annual Blackout Cancer Game for Southern Illinois, with all funds in the black jerseys going to Jerry Kill Cancer Fund. Let's hear from Barret Benson on what this game means to him.
Playing the Blackout Cancer Game means the world to me. It's an honor to play for such a great cause.
Blackout Cancer Game is important because we're playing for the people on the back of our dream.
It means a lot because I've personally been affected by cancer with my aunt. So to have a game where I can really bring light to cancer and light to her is really special to me.
We got a great crowd for this year's event, and they'll have a ceremony after to give away those jerseys that people have bid on.
Yeah, it's a really, really neat thing. Other schools around the country now are starting to do blackout events. It all started right here in football several years ago, and it's caught on famously around the country as well. What a cause.
Even Gray Dog sporting a black jersey tonight, the Saluki mascot. Final 4 minutes of this first half. Barret Benson gave the Salukis a little jolt there by taking a charge before the break. He's had his hands full with Krutwig. Here is Benson mid-post. We got Krutwig to back up, but he walked with it.
Just good defense by Krutwig.
Coach Bryan Mullins telling him to just go up with that already.
Loyola shooting 71% for the half. They have at least 8 of their field goals have been layups.
They're also one of the best two-point shooting teams in the country, mostly because of Krutwig. And a miss from long range from Clemens down to Benson. Start to this game, contested three for Francois.
So they never rotated the ball to the opposite side, just stayed on the right side on offense that time. Didn't make the defense move whatsoever. Kennedy called for the travel that time.
Good thing for both teams with the history of the staffs working together at Loyola. It's got to be almost like playing against yourself tonight.
In a lot of instances, I mean, when Loyola sets up their offense, Southern knows what's coming. It's just who's going to execute which portion better, the offense or the defense.
Well, especially defensively, talked about how there are a lot of back line principles with both teams. So Bryan Mullins made his mark with Loyola. And they've kept a lot of those principles. Seven seconds to shoot for Lance Jones. Falling away, that had no chance.
None. Great defense by Loyola.
Tate Hall's been held scoreless for Loyola. He's a big-time contributor for the Ramblers. And in the first meeting, Krutwig finally missed, but they'll get a second chance at it.
and Williamson was the only white shirt among four players under the rim, and he came up with that offensive rebound, and then it got knocked out of bounds by McGill. Look at Williamson, the only one under there with two black shirts right there, but he had the inside position. That can't happen. Can't give Loyola second and third opportunities.
Now Trutwig out of the game. Trent Brown comes away with the steal. Race to the rim with Agunani. And McGill trailing. And Benson cleaning it up.
Nice transition. All started with the quick hands of Trent Brown.
SIU probably feels like this is their chance to put a dent in a five-point deficit. Trutwig likely on the bench. Final 1:30 of the half. Oh, Agunani nearly took steps. Kept the pivot down, but missed it anyway.
Good defensive sequence by SIU.
Jones.
That must have been really exaggerated to call it. We couldn't see it all the way over the opposite side for us.
Got a groan out of you.
you just don't see that. No, not that I don't agree. They just don't call it. And he really wasn't gaining an advantage by palming the basketball out where he was doing.
Right. I think that's only maybe the second one we've seen this year. Pretty liberal with that call for much of the season. Williamson, Saluki's went under. Williamson couldn't make him pay. Trutwig is back in after a short break. Saluki's have numbers. Domask has his first bucket of the night.
Now you got to play defense. Loyola's got to work for their really good shot, which they've done all game long so far.
5 second differential, and everybody is standing after that Marcus Domask three here at Banterra Center. Skip for a Clemens three.
Plenty of time.
Inside five to go. McGill looking for Domask. Deep three at the horn. Top would have come off. And if that thing went down, SIU survived. Foul trouble to their point guard, Lance Jones. But against the first place, Ramblers are within two at halftime.
Closed well to get within two, that is for sure.
A couple of the top 15 defenses in the country there in that first half. Reverted to their offense, really. A couple of fine moments and stretches there for both teams on offense.
Yeah, the Salukis shooting at about 41%. Loyola is close to 55. Points in the paint has been huge for Cam Trutwig. Trutwig and his Ramblers have 20 points in the paint to the 14 for the Salukis. And how about getting your hands on the ball? Southern with five steals to Loyola's three.
What the official, what the referee say?
Well, he agreed with you. He said, for what it's worth, I didn't like the carry call either.
He's the one who did it.
For Lance Jones in the first half.
That's pretty funny.
Yeah.
You know, it's nice
and
though.
And he thought I was ripping him. It was you that was ripping him.
Not ripping. I
no,
just
gasping at him.
Yes.
Yeah.
Just kind of, really?
All right. Well, Domask had the big three before the break for SIU. Those are his only 3 points. He's SIU's leading scorer. Cam Trutwig, the opposite direction. He lived up to his top scoring billing for Loyola in the first half. What gives in half number two? Loyola trying to stay in first place. Northern Iowa up big. Loyola tied with the Panthers heading into the night. Williamson off on a three. That's how the second half begins. A stop for SIU. Southern had visions of getting into the first place at the end of the night. That would have taken a win here, a Northern Iowa loss.
That's not going to happen.
Still 6-3, a pretty good start for a team picked last in the conference.
I mean, Northern Iowa's not going to lose. They're up by 27 against Missouri State tonight.
We Uguak pestering Domask. Dive for the loose ball with Tate Hall. Uguak up ahead. Oh, and Jones gets his third foul less than a minute into the second half. It's probably one you just want to let go.
Yeah, you've got to let Uguak have that. You know you've got two fouls. Here's the knockaway by Uguak there. Domask and Hall both go for it. And Lance didn't get a lot of him, but enough to get his third foul.
Terrific floor burn work there from Hall to set that up.
Yeah. Dove and passed at the same time.
Hall without a basket in that first half, but still all over the floor on defense. Meanwhile, Uguak has picked up some of Tate Hall's scoring. He's got seven now. Loyola took a 10-point lead at the 4-minute mark of that first half. SIU stormed back into the half in an 8-0 run. It's Loyola scoring first in the second half on the Uguak free throw. Mask stutter steps, got to the bucket and one.
His strength on those drives to the basket is so impressive over the last several games. He did it at crunch time last Saturday against Illinois State. Got the big hoop for there. That time Uguak couldn't control him. Gets the bucket and the opportunity for the three-point play. And at Illinois State, he had just made two threes, one from either corner. So Illinois State's got to be thinking they're going to set him up for a three-pointer again. And then he drives it right down the lane and takes it to the basket.
That was a game that you just referenced, the last game for Domask. He missed seven of his first eight shots, then turned it on to hit six of his final eight and lead SIU to a come-from-behind victory.
He's now missed three free throws in a row, though.
Rutwick, strong drive, but Benson forces him to miss it short. Here come the Salukis. Gill led the team in the first half with 12 points. Nearly gave it away.
Plenty of time on the shot clock.
Gill in on Trutwig. And somehow he got it back. Three Ramblers were there. And McGill gets it stripped. Long lead pass for Clemens, no finish. Whistle may be loosening up a little bit since halftime.
Williamson with a really quick hand there. Fortunately, Southern able to stay in possession with 15 on the shot clock.
Williamson, a candidate for Defensive Player of the Year, switches on to Suggs, now getting late clock. High low for Domask. He had good position, but the pass way off.
Yep, way off, and he was holding and holding Uguak and then had to release, and when he released, the ball was already heading out of bounds.
Jones to the bench for SIU. Three fouls. Trent Brown in.
Trent played well in that first half.
Didn't score, but set up a transition opportunity for SIU with a steal. Rutwick, one-man offense. Benson fends him off. And Rutwick having a tough start to the second half.
Much better defense. Bellied him up, shouldered him up, never put his hands on him.
Benson banging in on Rutwick. Little baby hook.
The coat came off for Porter Mosier.
After that Rutwick miss?
Yep.
That one
he thought it, he thought he got fouled.
About 20 minutes longer than normally lasts. Uguak denied by Domask.
Might have been partially blocked there by Marcus. Got a hand on it.
And Porter thought there was a foul again. A button might come off.
now we're getting some defense played on both ends of the floor.
Both teams tied 13th in the country. 60.2 points a game on defense. And McGill has a chance to give the Salukis the lead.
And again, it's Uguak trying to contain the drive. He can't do it. Domask took him for a three-point play opportunity. And now McGill, with a great move, gets right by him, catches him with the body, and puts it in.
12, Marquise Kennedy,
be the first lead if Southern makes the free throw. They've not led in this game.
And here comes the crowd. They've been into it in these conference games. They've grown with each win, 8 in a row on the home floor, the Salukis. And Loyola has come out ice cold shooting in the second half.
Southern slows it down after nothing was there on transition.
And Damask got a mismatch on a smaller guard. Kennedy fouls him.
And Southern's going to go into the first break of the second half on top, thanks to Eric McGill's three-point play.
Two familiar staffs with each other. Bryan Mullins coaching against his former team, and they have solved Cam Krutwig at least so far in the second half.
He was 6-for-7 in the first half shooting the basketball, and we knew that Barret Benson would be challenged. And Barret, look at him bumping again and again, and not a great look by Cam Krutwig on that particular play. Here, another opportunity, nowhere to go really. Just threw one up, didn't go down, so Benson has done very well.
John with more on the old school big man.
Yeah, guys, everybody knows about Cameron Krutwig, the basketball player. What they may not know about is Cameron Krutwig, the singer, as a sophomore in high school. He and five of his buddies formed a singing group called the Six Cheersmen. Their genre was producing some brutal off-key renditions of Christmas carols. You can check him out on SoundCloud, but if you do, I'll warn you, it's not very good.
Oh, that's pretty good. I've heard that he lives by the three B's, the Beatles, Billy Joel, and the Chicago Bears. I like that. Good hit from John Miller. SIU just took their first lead, but give it right back in the turnover.
And a great feed from McGill to Benson. He just wasn't expecting. He thought Eric was going to take it to the hoop, and Eric probably could have taken it to the hoop on that one.
So an 0-for-6 start for Loyola in the second half. Who have two free throws. Porter Moser nearly got teed up at the timeout. He was out at half court, frustrated with some of the defense on Cam Krutwig. Kennedy left open. Rotation comes, and Trent Brown had the closeout to force the miss.
Kennedy missed that one pretty badly. You could see it from our end. It was not going to go down, and nobody there but Salukis to get the rebound. And Southern now will use a little clock to try to get everybody involved in the offense here.
These are the two teams that use the most clock. They play at the two slowest paces of anybody in the Missouri Valley Conference. We'll have another late clock as Brown throws it out of bounds off of Loyola.
Just 7 on the shot clock. Southern worked on quick hitting plays in their shoot around today.
See if Loyola knows what Bryan Mullins has drawn up from his time with them. Tightly contested three for McGill. He can't miss. 18 points for the senior.
Big time three as the shot clock was draining.
So it's now a 16-2 SIU run. They've got their biggest lead. Tate Hall still shut out. McGill passed on the three and scored it inside. Timeout, Loyola.
Listen to the crowd.
It's a new season high for Eric McGill. His biggest scoring output since the opener on November 5th against Illinois Wesleyan. Looking at the eye test, I'd say a good 5.5, maybe 6,000 here tonight, and they've not been a quiet 6,000. They've been a loud 6,000, and McGill just gave him a reason to get louder.
Eric McGill has been a a showman tonight. He's already got 20 points, ties his career high that he had when he was with Southeast Missouri against Missouri State. Look at the move on Ugwok to go for the three-point play. Then out of that last second shot, shot clock beater for three, and then the beautiful left hand and two caused Porter Mosier to call the timeout. Southern leads it by six.
Career high for him.
Career high, ties it with when he was with Southeast against Murray State back in 2016. And Krutwig back in the game.
The big man has been scoreless for Loyola after 13 first half points. And Suggs tramples Williamson for a foul.
Both guys going for the ball. Really, really tough call. And that's his third personal foul. And they will let him play. He's a grad student. He knows how to play with three.
He's got to write a thesis.
Exactly.
He knows how to play with three fouls.
And that was an excuse me foul. Both guys really going for the ball. And Michael Williamson just with a very lackadaisical attempt to get the ball to Krutwig. Knocked out of bounds.
This little offense late first half, we're shooting 75%. Now down to 45, but they get a quick one with Williamson. It snaps a drought of nearly 7 minutes without a field goal.
Just has a different gear tonight than we've seen all season long on his drives to the basket. 22 now, and every point from here on out is a career high.
Well, McGill capped the win here against Loyola last year with a steal. Threw a little bit of ire from the Loyola bench in the 10-point game. And there's Tom Welch missing the three. And it's out for the Salukis.
Davis back into the game for SIU. Davis replacing Ronnie.
Watch Eric here. Just splits and then accelerates to the basket.
Substitution for the Ramblers, number 30,
Ahir Ugwok. Krutwig lucky he didn't get a foul for the body there.
I was going to say McGill, ball and body have been one tonight.
Yes.
He's out there skating.
He does not want to come out.
Senior McGill that stuck around, maybe could have transferred again when the new staff came in. Brown's three rims out.
A perfect shot you want on the 1-3-1. Trent just didn't get it to go down. He's had looks tonight that were really good. None of them went down.
Double came for Krutwig, sixth sense. And Krutwig nearly had the hockey assist, but Clemens the miss.
They go back to the man-to-man. They'll probably play zone off of made baskets, but in transition, they've got to go back to the man-to-man.
Mascot doubled and a blocking foul.
And again out of Ugwok.
Fouls on 30, here Ugwok, his fourth personal foul.
And he's got four. And it almost went down. That would have been a big one.
Porter Mosier, the Loyola coach, keeps Ugwok on the bench for an extended stretch. Just inside 12 to go. The Salukis won by six.
For instance, Hall has not yet scored a bucket. Control Barret Benson, he's got seven. He's on his way to potentially nine. He only had two in the first ball game. Southern avoid long scoring droughts. They've done that very well. Make Loyola work hard for every point. The Ramblers are 1 of 11 here in the second half shooting the basketball.
It is the aforementioned mentioned Benson at the line. He missed his first and corrects on the second. SIU about 4 minutes ago took their first lead. It has grown to, it's now their biggest lead. That's seven right here. Rutwick smothered by a double. Out to Hall for a three. And Tate Hall is on the board for the first time tonight. A guy averaging 14 a game.
39th three. He shoots him at 44% coming into the ball game. They go back to the 1-3-1 zone now. Southern will have looks from the short corner or the corner. And Loyola got some size, so it's difficult to pass over the zone.
Davis slashing baseline. One on one and one.
Good look by Benson to a cutting Davis. Clemens did all he could, but fouled him. And now Karrington with an opportunity for the old-fashioned three.
Karrington Davis at the line, shooting one.
Tony, man, Karrington Davis, when right, he can be that third or fourth option sometimes, and that's fine, but he can be a number one option too.
And how long did he hang in the air? Porter Mosier doesn't play from behind very often this year.
Able to erase a 10-point deficit on the road at UNI Sunday to force overtime. And there's a good start for the Ramblers. Marquise Kennedy plus one.
Took that right at Barrett Benson.
Benson with his second personal foul.
And Barrett was backing up the entire time. Got him with the body. Kennedy has six. When he gets double figures, they are 8-1 this season.
Kind of a missing element. Lance Jones is going to come back into the game. But a missing element for Loyola last year. Their starters were really, really good. Porter Mosier was looking for a guy like Kennedy that could be instant offense off the bench.
Yeah.
By Kennedy tames this raucous Saluki crowd tonight. About 6,000 strong. Loyola tied with SIU as the number one defense in the conference. See if they can get a stop. Instead of foul on Hall, Domask back to the free throw line.
Again, a really good look and a hard cut by Domask coming off Barrett Benson's really nice pick. And almost got it to go down. Just the first foul on Hall. Marcus again has missed three straight free throws.
We were joking with him post game on Saturday. Who was wearing number one at the end of the game? Yeah, didn't recognize that guy. Domask has a chance to be the first guy in this program in a long time. Go 50-40-90. It's the free throw element right now that's holding him down.
And now it's getting to his head a little bit.
Lemons left open. Another brick.
Very lucky that time because Southern went under the pick and Clemens had all day to size up that three.
Virginia tempo. They model their defense after what Tony Bennett does with the Cavaliers. And a giveaway. Action Wojcik came in and also tagged a foul on SIU.
John Benson, his third now.
14 foul on the Saluki. Number one,
yep, just Williams a little too aggressive after trying to thread the needle there.
So the typically stoic head coach, Bryan Mullins. Two head coaches, former working mates, as Benson destroys that into the front row.
I'm kind of shocked Hall just didn't keep going to the basket and try to draw a foul that way. He just kind of lazed it up there and got swatted into the third row. That's That's two on Paul now. And Porter doesn't like that call whatsoever.
The change in strategy for SIU game one versus game two against Loyola, pretty obvious. Game one, it was takeaway Krupwig. Game two, it's takeaway Hall.
Yeah.
Hall had 16, 5, and 4. 16 points, 5 rebounds, 4 assists. Had anything he wanted in the first meeting. SIU's gotten a little bit sloppy.
It's so difficult to hold the guy off, maintain your position, and get that bounce pass that's going away from you, and just couldn't happen for Domask that time. Another turnover for Southern.
12 turnovers tonight. SIU knows how valuable those are. Back-to-back one-possession games that they're coming off of. Both wins. Brown riding Hall. Benson with a comeback block. Jones downhill, feeds Benson, offensive foul. A little bit of a show of agony for Benson. He just picked up number 4.
And what's amazing is one referee's making every call right now. Where was the foul? He just turned around. He's got to be given the ability to turn around. And now they're going to go look at it.
Yeah. Look for a flop, maybe.
I don't know if they're looking for a flop or if he got him with an elbow in the face just because he was turning around, much like in the Northern Iowa game last weekend. Difficult on that particular view to see it. But they're going to take a look at it. Still a 5-point advantage for the Salukis.
Williamson didn't give him space to operate, but he was in pretty good position.
Yeah. So they're going to look at it. It's a turnover regardless, so Loyola is going to get the ball back. Whether it's going to be a foul and the automatic 2 shots is going to be the difference. But now Benson with 4 personal fouls.
So if there is a reversal, this could be massive. Loyola's kept their footing despite going scoreless the last 2 minutes. And this has become more of the defensive battle that we expected from the jump. It was an offensive line in first half, but rugged second half.
Yeah, and Southern came out just clamping down on defense, and Loyola missed 10 out of their first 11 shots, which allowed Southern to get the lead and expand it to as much as 7. And right now it's hovering in that 4-5-6 range the last couple of minutes. Turnovers are picking up because defense is getting stickier and stickier on both ends.
Northern Iowa already won tonight, so SIU's chances of getting into first, not there anymore. Loyola will try to stay even with Northern Iowa and get to 7-2 as we reach the exact midway point tonight on our march to the arch, Sarge Madness. And there's an updated look after that Northern Iowa result. They beat preseason favorite Missouri State. The Bears underachieving, the Salukis overachieving, 5-3.
Yep, Drake and Indiana State are now both 5-4. We're going to get what's going on.
We just got an explanation.
Yep, just going to be a common foul. Very similar to the play down at the other end that they called a few minutes ago that they did not review. So it's just going to be Loyola basketball. But it's still the 4th foul on Barret Benson. So under 9 minutes to go. Southern is going to go with Suggs and Damask as their bigs, so to speak. And Marcus Domask gets the job of manning up with Cam Krutwig for a while. He's got the least amount of fouls, probably. Yeah, Suggs has 3.
Right. Nobody else that's on the floor right now, really for either team, has much foul trouble. The max on the floor right now for Loyola is 2. And Marquise Kennedy giving Loyola another nice lift on a drive.
just took the high pick from Krutwig and went right down the lane untouched for two.
Ramblers on a mini run. They've scored five of the last 6 points. Jalen Pipkins into the game again. For Loyola defensively. McGill's had the hot hand tonight, chose to give it up. And Suggs with his second three. That snaps the Saluki drought of almost 3 minutes.
Really nice look. Krutwig was coming over to probably block McGill's shot.
And Kennedy right back to it. He scored the last four for the Ramblers.
And he's got 11, and again, they're 8-1 when he gets in double figures. So if that holds true, it's going to be a good night for the Ramblers, but they do have the one loss when he did score double figures.
Ramblers, when Kennedy plays well and when they hit threes, almost unstoppable. And we've got a defensive foul.
And it's called on Krutwig, and he can't believe it.
Oh, they got that on. Wow. Just Krutwig's first. Pipkins that took that chest.
And that's why Krutwig can't believe it, but they're saying he pushed him right there with the body. Yes, because he called it on Krutwig immediately, but we'll find out after the break.
We're seeing ghosts. Upcoming home events at SIU brought to you by Carbondale Tourism. It's the Blackout Cancer Game on Friday against Illinois State. Big weekend. That Illinois State Bradley swing for Coach Cindy Stein and her team have picked up a weekend sweep following their ranked win over Missouri State. And swimming has Evansville. Men's basketball back home against Missouri State after a trip to Drake and Evansville.
Yes. Southern is on that Saturday swing of games currently.
It's Dog Days time, isn't it?
It is Dog Days time. Tonight will be the halfway point. And everybody in the league is playing tonight, so everybody will have completed 9 games after tonight with 9 left to go as we head towards literally 1 month left in the season. It's crazy.
One of the beauties of this league, Ronnie Suggs at the free throw line. One of the beauties of this league, which is becoming rarer with conference expansion, one of the few leagues left with a true round robin.
Yeah.
Going to play everybody twice, home and road. Didn't lead in the first half. Southern's led by as many as 7 in the second half. Trying to hang on and beat Loyola, who came into the night in first place. And Clemens left all alone on the baseline.
And Southern not doing a very good job of keeping their guy in front of them. Back to the 1-3-1.
Loyola gets their best defender, Lucas Williamson, at the top of it. Jones. Oh, that three-point shot coming on for Lance Jones.
Thing of beauty. And making threes will bring him out of a zone in a hurry. Ties the largest lead of the game for the Salukis.
Looks like Jones might be a non-factor in this game. Picked up 2 fouls in the first 4 minutes. That was a massive shot. Oh, it's been Kennedy's second half for the Ramblers.
He's got 10 in the second half alone.
Yeah, with very little scoring from Cam Krutwig, he has picked it up. So blow for blow. Here we are at a 4-point game again. Mask had a wide open look.
Yep, really good look.
Kennedy takes Brown, and Kennedy's tear continues. 2-point game. Rookies Kennedy has 12 in the second half, and that's his second time where he's had back-to-back baskets for the Ramblers.
Southern has given up 4 layups out of the last 5 made baskets by Loyola. Here's the 3 that he hit, but they've given up a lot of layups. Just driving right by, and there's nobody there because Krutwig is out at the free throw line, and there's no reverse help because they're afraid of kicking it outside for a wide open three. So you've got to keep the man in front of you and prevent that guy from getting to the basket.
Loyola head coach Porter Moser has been a head coach for a long time. Three schools. It's his ninth year at Loyola. He said that head coach or assistant, any player he's ever coached, Kennedy is the quickest he's ever had.
Well, it looks like he is. Really, really quick first step. And it's a job for anybody, let alone Trent Brown. And Trent now out, Benson back in.
Well, SIU's got to be careful. They have six on the floor.
Who's in, Suggs or Trent Brown?
That could have been bad.
Yep. So it is going to be Trent still in the game.
Loyola also had six on the floor. Their head coach, Porter Moser, was almost out of the jump circle.
So who's going to make stops? Who's going to make plays in these final 6 minutes? It's going to decide it.
Jones sat down. Ball popping around. Mask off on the three.
And Clemens really came out and challenged.
And deflected off of Clemens out of bounds.
Really nice job by Lance Jones. Got a pinky on it. And Clemens couldn't control it. It went off of him. McGill's been quiet for about the last 4 or 5 minutes.
He's got a game high 22. McGill rips through. And no deflection.
Oh, that'll be changed. That'll be changed. Brad Gaston did not see it, but everybody else in the gym saw it.
Brown, an aggressive drive. Krutwig meets him at the rim.
Really nice, quick hands by Cam Krutwig. Trent brought it right straight up, where Cam had a really easy opportunity to put all hand on the ball. Five on the shot clock.
Tough catch. Jones falling away. Oh, almost went glass. So Loyola's gotten their stops. They've held SIU scoreless for almost 3 minutes. It's a methodical 5-0 run. All the points from Kennedy. All in the hands of the freshman. He gets downhill and scores on Damask. This game is tied.
14. For Kennedy here in the second half, 18 on the game. And they are tied at 4.5 to go.
17 in the first meeting for Kennedy with SIU. And he's been the best player in the second half. Cam Krutwig still out without a basket for the Ramblers. Great pass from Damask. Ends up in the hands of Benson. And the tie is short-lived.
The chess match in this final 4 minutes is going to be fun to watch.
They get McGill coming over the screen against Kennedy.
Only the sixth foul, though, on the Salukis. They're not the bonus yet.
Well, this would be one that would put the league on real notice. SIU looking for their fourth consecutive win. This one would be against the league leader, Loyola. Southern looking for back-to-back home wins that would be signature wins. It would be their ninth win in a row in this building. And back-to-back wins against the first-place team. They just beat UNI last week. And they're at 356 away. But Marquise Kennedy doing everything he can.
He had 17 against the Salukis in the game at Loyola. He's turned it on here in the second half with 14 second half points. A lot of them via just blowing by people to get to the basket. He's hit a three as well. He's done it all for this Rambler team when his teammate Mr. Krutwig scoreless here in the second half.
Kennedy went to Brother Rice High School in Chicago. The reason he chose Loyola is because he hit it off with Saluki head coach
Bryan Mullins. The biggest difference in this game from the first game is Tate Hall. Loyola won that game by 16. Hall had a bunch in that game. He's only got three today.
It was a three that came in the second half for Hall. Williamson, he's had a quiet offensive night. And Krutwig, a second chance on the tap out. Krutwig barrels in. Still nothing in the second half.
Big stop on defense. Can you execute on offense? Each team has two timeouts remaining.
McGill, another one of those signature crossover moves. He's got 24 to add to his career high.
4-point lead under 3 minutes.
Kennedy calls a timeout. Arrow favored SIU. Kennedy saves the possession.
Good defense by Benson. Moved his feet that time. Didn't try to reach. And caused Kennedy to fall down. And when reaching to try to tie it up, he called timeout. Here's McGill back on that other end. Just another gear. Puts it in. Hall can't stay with him.
I'll tell you what. You mentioned Tate Hall being a difference. The defense there came from Barret Benson to force the Loyola timeout. Barret Benson, one rebound shy of a double-double. That's a huge jump from the first game against Harwin.
He was almost invisible in that first ball game. But Barret has come alive on the boards. He's got at least one block, maybe two. Let's see if they give him credit for two.
He had two on back-to-back trips down.
Yep. So he's stuffed the stat sheet. There's AC Aaron Cook cheering his mates on.
Season, the senior guard for the Salukis, injured hand. Tate Hall buries a three.
It's a nice call out of the timeout, isn't it?
Sure is. And a big shot from Hall, who's been frustrated much of the night. 1-point game. Here we go. 2.5 minutes to play. Rutwig came in late. Off the Ramblers.
Not a bad pass from Ronnie Suggs, but again, it would have had to thread a needle that wasn't quite there.
And Krutwig shifts in late, doesn't he?
Really does. Plenty of time on the clock.
Gill hems himself in, gets away from trouble. And Benson, a big man three. And that noise deafens even further.
You just don't play better defense than that. Didn't give him any looks at all. Williamson's shot was a good look, but it was a forced three. The only people sitting down are Connor and me right now.
Gill's had the hot hand. Got to go, though. Benson got it off, but short. Some contact there. Rutwig with good defense. Two-possession game. A little over a minute to go. Kennedy. Over the backboard and out of bounds. Hard to hear the whistle right now. That jam-packed dog pound, and Porter Moser thought there was a foul.
And one of the best things about Loyola having to call that timeout was they've only got one left. They've only got one timeout left.
1 minute remaining to play. 1 minute.
60 ticks to go to be Trent Brown to the line for a 1-1.
It's the ninth team foul, so after this, Southern will be in the double bonus.
25, Cameron Quedlin back in for Loyola.
SIU was outplayed in the second half just 2 weeks ago. Man, how things have changed. Since then, SIU has not lost.
Shooting one plus to bonus.
And they can remain just a game out of first place and climb into second to close this out.
Brown on the year now, 11 for 13 from the line. And he can make it two full possessions.
Suave to the freshman. He bangs a pair. 6-point game. Brutwick got a lead block, still can't buy one, and now he has his first points of the second half. Still a very nervous energy in this building right now. 2-on-1, but Brown will peel it out.
Excellent move by Trent.
Looks like Loyola was trying to foul, and now they get it.
And the Salukis' best player the last five games goes to the free throw line. He gets two shots with 33.8 left in the ball game.
Aaron McGill at the line shooting two.
Boy, he just, as Dan Patrick would say back in the day, and Fuego, he's done nothing wrong in this game.
English speakers, that means on fire. Back to six. Loyola have an answer. Clemens looking for the quick two. Oh, he squeaks it past Benson. And the final timeout taken by Loyola and Porter Mosley.
This is fun. This is college basketball. This is what the Banterra Center is all about for the Salukis. As Clemens knifed his way in there, didn't he? Look him split the two guys to get that layup to go to pull them to within four. 25.4 left. It's going to be a free throw shooting contest now because Loyola has to foul and has to foul quickly. So Southern's going to get its best guards in the game, and don't be shocked if they run that long touchdown pass as well to try to get an easy one.
Well, Loyola's targeted, right? They're going to get the best road crowd. Final Four, NIT, back-to-back regular season champs. They get the promotional game every year.
Sure.
For every game.
And they should. They've earned it. When you go to the Final Four and you continue to do well, you get everybody's best shot.
Salukis will close out their toughest four-game stretch of the season on Saturday at Drake. The Bulldogs have won 15 in a row at home. But you went into this, if you're SIU, you and I, first in the conference, top 50 in the net. Illinois State, great at home. Loyola, top of the conference. Drake, 15 in a row at home. You thought 2-2 would be a win. Yeah. SIU's potentially thinking 4-0 if they can close this one out.
If they can close this one out, meaning you've got to get the ball in bounds, number one, and then you've got to make free throws. You get two every time you get fouled.
Ukwok will guard the inbounder. He's the best overall athlete Loyola has to offer. Suggs the inbounder. Oh, and a tenuous moment there in the corner. And it's back to Loyola.
25, Cameron Crumpley checking in for the
only place you don't want to catch the inbounds pass is in the corner, right where McGill caught it. You're going to see it right here. He must have stepped out of bounds. So Loyola has it, down four.
That's pretty much Keith Clemens all by himself. Well, what's Loyola thinking? Go for a three or a quick two? The answer is a three. Williamson misses, and out to Southern.
That was a great look from Lucas Williamson. There were two white shirts to rebound the basketball, and they kind of fought each other. Went out of bounds. Couldn't ask for a better play drawn up, even though it wasn't drawn up. Just didn't work.
McGill in that corner again, and a quick foul.
And this crowd is still on its feet. Southern still has two timeouts. And McGill back to the line.
Eric McGill is at the line for the Salukis. McGill shooting two.
Southern going for nine in a row at home for the first time since a decade ago. 07-08. No matter what here. Two possession game, even if McGill made both of these.
Yep.
Lance Jones checking in for SIU, replacing Barret Benson.
Jones is in for some defense, and SIU will vacate the lane lines.
Yep, pure guards in there now for both teams.
And they'll put two on the lane lines. Right, timeouts left for Loyola. 5-point game.
27 for McGill. Got to make him catch it in the backcourt.
Lemons pushed off. Stop and start. Goes for the two. It's off. Rebound to Mask. Kicked out to McGill. Final seconds. And the league has been put on notice. Southern is for real. With a 6-3 start.
Eric McGill, the best player Southern's had the last five games, carried this team in the first half and made huge plays down the stretch in the second half for Southern to get this victory and now be in second place in the league. Four in a row, the hottest team in the league as they head to Drake on Saturday.
Wow. Pick 10th. SIU now in second, still a long way to go.
Long way to go, we're only halfway through. But what's nice is Loyola's done. You've played Loyola twice. You've played Illinois State twice, and you'll finish with Drake twice on Saturday. You've got Evansville twice. You still get Indiana State at home. You still get Missouri State twice, but at home. You get Evansville at home. They're on the road more in the second half, 5-4, but Southern's for real right now.
Seems naive to think that they could compete for a conference championship in the preseason. Just one game out with nine games gone. Eric McGill tonight, he was the man of the 2 hours, 27 points, a career high for him.
Eric, nine straight at home, 10-1 on the year. What is so special about this place?
I just love the energy here. Fans, they give us a lot of energy, and I just thank you for it.
You guys were picked 10th in the league. Halfway through the conference schedule, you're in second place. What did you guys know that nobody else did?
Yeah, we're a very hard-working team. We're in the gym every day, and each and every one of my teammates won. So we're just going to keep working hard, keep progressing.
Career high, 27 points for you in front of this crowd. What does it mean to do it on the stage?
I love it. I'm just grateful. You know, my teammates really gave me the confidence, and coach just trusted me, and I just thank both of those.
Go enjoy it. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
Eric McGill, guys.
Great work, John. Great work, Eric McGill. 27 points. He would have willed him to it if he had to down the stretch tonight. He got most of his work done early.
Yeah, and again, he just seemed to play in a different gear tonight than anybody else on the floor until Marquise Kennedy played in that same gear for Loyola in the second half and almost single-handedly brought the Ramblers back to this one. But Southern made more plays down the stretch, both offensively and defensively, to put this one away.
Well, not many saw this coming, but Southern's in the race, a la Drake and Missouri State, with low expectations in the preseason.
A lot of fun.
A lot of fun. Big thanks to our statistician, Roman, down here on Press Row tonight. Our entire crew, led by Dennis Galloway, our producer, back in the truck. Mike True, John Miller on the sidelines. I'm Connor Runyon. It's a final from Carbondale. SIU is 6-3 for the 68-63 win over the first place Loyola Ramblers. Catch our next telecast, Saluki Men's Basketball. February 1st, the Salukis are on the road to Des Moines to play Drake at on our ESPN family of networks. Log on to watchESPN.com or download the Watch ESPN app. Thanks for watching. This has been a presentation of the Missouri Valley Conference on ESPN.